What up? You live on Opinionated News Network. I am your gracious host, Mr. Trent St. James in the building. I'm over here with Kontrol. Kontrol, say hi.
When did I meet you? Did I meet you when you first started dancing? Yeah, I was like 21 when I
I took you over to the priesthood, right?
You're the first person to take you.
Yeah. And your back, I was 10 toes down. I had all my boots on the ground. I want to keep it real with the people. The people want to know.
St. Louis ain't the place to strip either. It's not. Go somewhere else. Go to Texas. Get some money.
Yeah.
Texas. I wouldn't say Atlanta, but yeah, they make money, but it's...
Do you know girls that lie, that fuck with a nigga and lie about?
If the stripper tells you they made $300 that night, they really made $40,
$60,
if not
$150,
or
$10 out there. She's very pretty. The fuck y'all say that like y'all expect something less? This is my... Boom right here. Like, sure.
Anyway.
Ask her whatever y'all want to ask. Your name is Kontrol. That's me.
Thank you,
man. Tell them, right, tell them where they can find you at. You feel me? I want to blow your shit up.
Oh, my God.
Hold on.
Crazy, but I fuck with y'all. Y'all keep it real.
There you go.
I'm scared of y'all too.
scared as shit.
I'm scared of them in bed. They're aggressive. I'm scared. Get you in there, you're gonna be doing shit you didn't thought of.
Patron.
I'm drinking
Patron. I'm on that absolute, baby. I'm on the absolute.
Okay,
man.
He better not be.
So, can you tell the people, like, what it is? Can you tell the people, like, what type of dude I am? Because a lot of people be sitting up in here lying on me. You know what I'm saying? They be telling you I'm fake. I ain't no real nigga. Can you tell these niggas I be out in the streets ever since you know I be out and been out here?
And can I be real?
Yeah.
This is nothing. Aries tell the truth, though. We don't give a fuck. You put your nose into situations sometimes without you knowing it. Because you're easy, like, not easy, but like, you're an easygoing person. But, like, you don't fuck with a lot of people. But the people that see that you fuck with, they're going to take that to the good. So you put yourself in certain drama that you don't need to be a part of.
Like what? Let me tell you. Let me tell you in front of my people. I didn't have shit to do with it. I'm telling, when I'm telling you, she came to me. That's what I'm supposed to do. I'm not supposed to be talking behind your back. That's whatever's going on in the locker room and all that. I ain't got shit to do with it. I don't know.
Ashley is my girl, man. Like, we
tighter than that, man. She on that bullshit, all right? She wanted me to get in the middle of that drama, man. I don't get in the middle of that motherfucking drama. They was both wrong. On everything I love, they was both wrong. That was both wrong.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw the people this bitch on us back in the day. This is me and her back in the day. You hear me? Hold on. God damn. Where the fuck all this blur come from? This is us back in the day. This 3 years ago. You hear me? Hold on. Let me see. Can y'all see? This is us 3 years ago. That's how long we've been rocking like a cut-off stock.
No, my hair grow out, I'ma cut it. Whenever it gets to this point, and then use my own hair.
I ain't cutting my hair. This is my second mother right here.
Hold on,
Donna Strickland came in. We gotta play bump and grind for her. We got to play bump and grind.
That's her favorite. She's
not gonna
hear it.
She'll hear it.
Tell him to play it on the radio. You put cutie pie, you the reason. reason why.
You heard me. They say I'm wild. Yes, I am. I am. You
thank
are
you.
Beautiful too. Listen, my people ain't haters. They not haters. They want you to come on and do a full show. You hear me? See a beautiful
hey,
sister?
Can I borrow this? Can I have this?
Yeah, go ahead, bro. Go ahead. Hey, baby girl, baby girl. Hey, baby girl.
I love you, son.
I don't want you to go. You hear me? Listen. Listen, they want to see you go to Chicago with me. You gonna come to Chicago?
Wait till the Corona shit, man. Wait, when the Corona shit.
They got a march plan for R. Kelly. See, this right here, that's R. Kelly's sister right there. You feel me? That right there. She want to see you in Chicago on July 18th. You gonna go? You gonna go for real? They want to know.
I just know I can't go home for 2 weeks because I got the visa.
But are you gonna go though?
If people, I can.
Will you though? You say you can. Okay. Can you tell the people whether or not you gonna come to Chicago with Trent? Come represent. Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh shit! They say we family now. They gonna welcome you over here. I'm telling you. My people love you. You feel me? They love you. I'm telling you, it's gonna be all love. You heard me? Listen, post your stuff again because the people, they don't know your Instagram. The people want to know. That's the Instagram right there. Go and follow her. Listen. We popping bottles, of course. Every time I'm with her, we kicks it. And it don't never be 1 hour, 2 hours. It's always like 6, 7, 8 hours. Every time. You feel me? Even when she left me for the light-skinned niggas. I still love her. Tell her watch out for the ops. Listen, when you tell them if the ops come, what you gonna do? They say if you with me, you gonna be taking care of. That's it. That's all. You that's it. That's all. Listen, this is my sister Sharon right here. You hear me? What up, Daddy Lolo? Now I gotta get one of them jackets. What's the size? It's all on my website, opinionated.com. APINYUNAP. Opinionated.com. That's how we doing it. Thank you, son. I can't hear it. Love you, son. Have a good time. You hear me? Every time I'm with Ashley, it's always a good time. Okay? All right, yes, thank you, feel me? Listen, I do not make a profit off of any of those jackets, all right? I don't make a profit off of none of it. Which one? Yeah, I don't make a profit off of it.
I was talking about already straight to Facebook.
You say what? It's really about getting the message out there, you feel me? Especially with all of the Black Lives Matter shit that's going on right now. You know what I mean? Let me turn this on me a little bit. Okay, there you go. So, the people, they need to know that ain't none of the money going towards me. So none of the money goes towards me. I'm not in this for the money, you know what I mean? I'm in this for all that. Matter of fact, can you tell these people that I ain't no broke nigga? Ever since you know me, I ain't never been broke, man. The king of R&B, not R.I.P. God damn it. These people, I think I'm stealing this shit.
I don't be stealing, man. They talk about I'm a scammer. Have you ever known me to be a scammer?
Murder cow.
capital. You feel me? That these motherfuckers don't know. The only key to survive is you know what I'm saying?
Get to carry a gun or some type of shit. I got a taser in my ass. I got it. This is where me if I crash into a lake, I can crash out my window, but if one of y'all motherfuckers shot me, I said
they say my foot gonna take good curls. You feel me? You up in the building. It's your show. Tell the people what it is. There you go. The people love you. Go ahead and talk to the people. They love you.
Nice.
It's 76 people up in here right now that love you.
Thank you. I love you too.
Listen. Tell them. You feel me? What word is? You know that how I met you. What the situation was like? You know.
You've been cool. You met me in the strip club, but it's never been like a. We had real conversations. It wasn't no fucking bullshit.
Hey.
I didn't have my problem. I wouldn't be sitting right here if I had a problem. Thank you.
There you go. Good for you.
Thank you.
Make it rain on her, Trent. You feel me? I didn't shower with her with my love. God damn it. Motherfucker.
He has helped me out. I'll be the person like, hey, yo, Trent, I need $100 or $200, whatever. He'd be like, okay, it's for a good cause. He'll only tip it just for a good. If he know you, they ship it goes like if you know my person. If he knows you, he will take care of you. He ain't no fucking fucking YouTube scandal. He can't handle it.
She can't handle me. You hear me? I long dick and light, huh? No, listen. Trent about to get an invoice. Hell nah, listen. Listen, man, listen. She won the honey all the way around, all right? You feel me? I ain't shit, so I wouldn't even do her read, you know what I mean?
$100 out of it.
Now, how do you feel about a bitch that be lying about selling pussy?
Fucking save. That's how a lot of the fucking NBA player, NBA girls. A baby's not gonna save nothing. I can have a baby by this man right here and still be paid. I can still get a good child support from him.
Listen,
but I'm gonna give me a fucking business.
With me, baby, you ain't gotta have no child support.
No, look up. Not even child support. I'm just saying, I can be fucking with you and have child support from her. And have personal credit card.
Nigga, this corona shit is over. We back out here. We are out here. Yes. We are out here. You can't. There you go. Y'all know her. All right. Shit. She dead. Y'all thought I was lying about new strippers. No. I don't have no reason to lie. I don't fuck with nothing but bad bitches. Period. Who fuck with nothing but bad bitches? That's it. Listen. I'm always saying. Y'all don't even know. Listen. Me and her, we came into, you know what I'm saying? I met her as soon as she came into the game. Period. I met her when she came into the game. That was it. That was it. I met her as soon as she came in. I always have looked out for her. Period. I always looked out for her. You feel me? This is me and her. Y'all see, I don't got no face to her right there. I don't have no face to her. You hear me? Yeah, it's always gonna be fire. Hold on, where the fuck you at? Listen, I'm finna show y'all me another Aries bitch. Listen, if y'all want me to show y'all my other Aries bitch that I fuck with, I'm gonna show y'all. Bill, That marks. If she comes, I go. Other than that, I'm not going to that mark. All right. If she comes, I go. But other than that, I'm not going. What do you mean? But her ass fat and all. Lily, her ass fat and all. Listen. What do you mean? What you mean? We gotta play this shit off like y'all ain't see her. Play this shit off, y'all. Play it off. There you go. There you go. Wipe her and see her ride.
I'm an Aries.
They say wipe you. Do you think you are a Marianne type right now?
I'm 24.
Right now, though, that's because I know I'm not mentally there. Okay. Will you tell something to these people who try to keep getting me to bury you?
He not real. That's all I'm gonna say.
You still my boo, though. So July 18th, they holding a rally in Chicago. They holding a rally in Chicago. They want you to come. If you come, I will go. If you don't go, I'm not going to go.
I'm legal. He used to ask me that all the time. He'd be like, are you even legal to be in this bitch? That's
29. She is the age she says she is.
I'm 24.
She the age that she say she is, period. All right?
I'm going back on the comments. I can't see spending over $1,000 on clothes and person. You really don't. I'll go to Target, quick as hell. Don't break your back trying to impress everybody else.
They say marriage, she still living like she wants to. Marriage is overrated.
Yeah.
This is the real me. Y'all don't understand. This is the real me. Okay?
Exactly. I'm supposed to be living up, getting my shit together. So whenever I do have kids.
You're supposed to be getting that pussy ate from the bag. What the fuck you mean? All right. She looking at me straight. Girl, that's because you ain't grow with them motherfuckers.
I know. It's not in my real house.
You just got all hers. All of a sudden, shit. When that shit grow over time, you just don't notice it.
Yeah.
Only time I notice that I got her is when I'm in the shower and all that shit.
People drive a Cadillac. I'm gonna pay my car.
You the only motherfucker I know who will wreck a car and get a new one.
That's the bitch I put my money
up. You feel me? Shit.
I'll crash a car and get 2017 next.
That's how she little though. Hold on. Tell them you all woman. Damn, that ass still fat though. Come on. Shit. You putting that shit in your car? Okay, I'm about to circle back around here. Listen, y'all. Bite size. You real shit. That make you want to eat it if she bite size, right? Fuck you mean? She short. I like short bitches. What the fuck y'all talking about? What you mean? She short. The fuck? Is her pussy pink? Nigga, the fuck? Y'all trying to tell me something? Long as she ain't a man. Y'all didn't say she was a man, though. Fuck is y'all talking about? Keisha Boo, how tall is you? What the fuck is she short? Azriel short. Oh, shit. My cord all fucked up. I probably shouldn't even be driving. I will show y'all my Listen, I would show y'all my credentials and shit, but you know, Wishbone and Sharon, they'll be like, nigga, no. So let me take this shit off. Let me take all this shit off. Listen, man, y'all. Listen, yes, he is a stripper. Okay, yes, nigga, fuck. I'm like freaks. Okay, I'm like. I can't fuck with a regular bitch. Is that ass fat though, Keisha Boo? Keisha Boo, is that ass fat though? You ready? No, nope, nope, don't do it now. Hold on, y'all. Levi shades. Shit. Shit, I know ass. They ugly as hell. Otherwise, I would holler. You take Crick T Mom? Oh, yeah. You sure do. Fuck. You sure do. Listen, I gotta do that live with FaZe and them later on. Listen. Y'all Chicago motherfuckers, y'all gotta get more organized, man. That's the only thing. Move that motherfucker around. You hot? Kurt, I'll turn that shit up. Kurt, there you go. Now you can turn your own side up right there. Keisha Boo said she 5'2". She look big.
Yeah, I'm 14.
You 5'2". There you go. So I got a question. Creamer or squirt? That's a question I ask everybody. I ask them, creamers or squirters? You know what I mean? The people want to know.
That means she a creamer, dog. All right. Squirters make themselves home. You hear me? Squirters make themselves home. All right. Her got a charge. Yes. There you go. Alright, it's here with me. Alright, there. Ashley looks 5'10 to my right. 5'10? Where did she get 5'10 from? Ashley 4'10, goddamn. Where did she get 5'10 from? There, take her. Listen, shit, turn the thing on you. They don't want to see you. They don't want to see my ass. Well, shit, you can hold it, man. You can move that motherfucker over to that vent, though.
You don't have no magnetic here? Can't you stand up in your vehicle?
That's not work.
How can I stand up in your vehicle?
You probably can. You ain't had it once, you know, it's like a crab, isn't it? You can. That's it. That's all. What the ass in the chat?
I'm sorry, I'm a little drunk. What y'all up to today? What y'all cooking today?
Who the fuck got a barbecue plate for, nigga? What we coming to on the 4th? Ask them, nigga, where can we pull up at and get a plate on the 4th? Yeah. Listen. It was three motherfucking haters that disliked this video. Fuck these niggas.
Who?
I don't know whoever the haters are.
Okay, yeah. Thank you. Y'all give me so many compliments. I don't know what
to do. They're just so happy to see you.
I'm the real MVP.
Most valuable what?
Person.
All right. Most valuable
play. Play too. I'm so proper, y'all. Yeah. I'm from Kansas City.
I'm from Kansas City. What's your dream job?
I want to own a marketing
firm. Okay. She said her husband said you're beautiful because you're natural.
Thank you. No, I want to own the marketing. I went to school for marketing. All I got to do is finish like a year and a half up. And I'm cool. And
then,
shit, I just trying to get back in school.
How many kids you got?
None.
Some kids.
Yeah, I like 2 to 3. 3 at the most, but 2. If I get a boy and a girl, I'm done.
Okay. What's your favorite color?
Pink and purple, like an average person.
What's your type?
Ooh, shit. You got neck bones? I just cooked some neck bones yesterday.
They want to know what's your type.
I'm not going to lie. I like good niggas, but I like niggas that got something going on. Something like a drive. You gotta have a drive. Like, if you up, but know what to do whenever you down now. So if I am potatoes, I'm on some really good greens and cornbread right now.
What's your type?
Brie. respectful. I'm not gonna lie, I like mean people. Like, I like a nigga that's like mean to everybody else, but not mean to me. Mm-hmm. Ask me all questions.
What's the craziest question you ever had sex?
They're not even asking me these questions.
They texting them.
What? Let me see.
Right here.
You lying.
I am lying. But this is a question that I ask. Man, the people want to know, what's the craziest place you ever had sex at? We trying to make this shit go viral. It's 300 people watching.
Can you put me out? Mm-mm. Nah.
Man, it's 300 people watching.
Shit, I sure don't have a seatbelt on either.
Listen, it's 355 people that are watching this video. They want to know.
Okay, but they're not asking that type of question. If they want to ask that type of question, they
can. Ask the real questions, y'all.
He just trying to know for himself. What happened to your shit, though?
What is this? Shit, nigga, that's my fake seatbelt thing. What's your favorite R. Kelly song? No.
This nigga. So, shit. My mind's telling me no. My mind. Oh my god, he made so much shit. It's not insane. He got so many, like, I like his Coke Closet, Chapter Closet series. Now, he's talented, though. Now, he's talented anyway, but he was real.
Can you, have you ever been trapped in a closet?
No.
Have you ever had a nigga trapped in a closet? Have you ever been locked up before?
Yeah, I went to jail once for 12 hours. That's for traffic tickets.
Have you ever been handcuffed up?
Yeah. Remember, I was on Snapchat and I posted, like, my ass going to jail. And you were just like, what the fuck?
I don't know, sure. I don't think
that's cool. No, I was sitting in the cop. That cop was actually pretty cool. Mm-hmm. I was on live and everything whenever I was getting arrested.
What's your dream destination?
I want to go to Brazil.
Who's your celebrity crush?
I'm not gonna lie, I love me some Boris Kojo. But Usher was like my crush for like 8 years.
Do you speak any foreign language?
Slightly Portuguese.
Say something in Portuguese, like.
Bila, esto, it's like slightly, and I don't know, I forgot it now, but I know what it is.
What's your dream car?
A Lamborghini with a Range Rover as an SUV.
You like sports?
Basketball, football.
What's your favorite sports team in basketball? Yes, we.
I like Golden State.
Okay, what's your favorite? You a bandwagon.
Not really, no, because I was already with Steph Curry whenever he was at Davidson College. I'm more like a college basketball fan.
Okay, so what's your favorite college team?
So like Davidson and Duke.
Okay, so you like North Carolina people. Mm-hmm. Okay, what's your favorite NFL team?
Chiefs.
I'm
from Kansas City, so.
Light skinned niggas or dark skinned niggas?
I like any skin tone for real, but I tend to see myself with more light skinned niggas.
Okay. Shit, long hair, short hair.
Okay, I was bald headed. So. I kind of like the long hair, but not really.
Romantic or you need the pants?
Both.
Okay.
You can't. No. You can't be romantic if you don't have a passion.
What's your favorite holiday?
My birthday.
It's not a holiday.
My birthday's a holiday. Yeah, I was born on Easter. So, yeah.
Easter.
I was born on Easter. My nickname is Buddy. My real nickname is Buddy.
What's the craziest thing you ever did?
Oh, stop by gas stations, brother. Honestly, I'm not gonna lie. Shit, this the most crazy shit I've done is start skipping for real. I haven't done really nothing stupid, like throwing up parties. Like, my uncle, my brother was the one that was, like, doing a crazy stupid shit. I never did. Mm-mm.
What city have you ever visited that you would love to live in?
Austin, Texas.
Why so?
Because the diversity and the, Southern people to me, a lot of people got misconstrued kind of like picture of people in the South, but it's like they're kind of, they're hospitality. It is what it is in the South. It's not, it's just a hospitality. They know how to, it comes, even if you do your dirt, it comes natural to treat a girl right. It comes natural to do whatever the hell they're going to do instead of just do whatever. Midwest people do that shit.
What's your drug of choice?
Weed. Okay. I smoke a lot of weed.
Okay.
You got big man. I used to have them tears. Yeah, I took them out. I had surgery. I actually broke my ankle. If y'all want to see my ankle scar. I'm sure.
You know what I'm saying? You see
them? Oh, hell yeah. Damn.
Did
you see the other one?
Damn. What the fuck that happened?
Remember, I was out of work for 3 months.
Girl, we follow you like this.
Well, I was out of work for 3 months. What was the question again?
Do you see our nudes?
Yeah, if you're my nigga, hell yeah. I'm a sex dude, nude you. No, and shit. If you my nigga, hell yeah. I'll be, okay, hey, I'm taking a shower. What's up? Okay. I'd be quick with the showers.
Okay. Dirty talk, or you just like the young guy to shit up? Dirty talk, and you like, you gotta shut up.
You gotta talk to me. You can't just like, I don't want you talking to me the whole time, but
you
gotta
be like, oh, girl.
Yeah, like, yeah. Nasty. Yeah.
Like, hey.
Yeah, and then that's it. Don't be like, oh, I don't.
Okay.
Don't
okay,
be extra. Okay.
What's your favorite place to eat?
I love seafood. So, my favorite place to eat, I like Oyster Bar and pasta. So, like,
Maggiano's
or something.
Jeans or leggings?
Leggings. I got a little bit too thick.
Mmm. Okay. What's your favorite type of music?
R&B and rap.
R&B. What's your favorite songs? Who your favorite artists?
I like Moneybagg. I can't stand Megan Thee Stallion or Sweetie.
Why come?
Megan Thee Stallion always make remix of shit. They don't really have, like, she don't really have anything of her own. Sweetie okay. is just like, it's just a pretty face that just so happens there.
So let me ask you that. Do you think that a lot of the shit that Megan Thee Stallion be talking before Fetch Outlandish?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because a lot of people don't have to be in her position to do all that shit. If anything, you're saying how you got there. They're promoting. I feel like music right now, just like, it doesn't make any sense. Honestly, I just listen for the beat. So it's just like they're promoting shit that they can't even do themselves. Like, it's going to make it impossible to be like, for everybody to beat up, because they're going to be so heartbroken mentally and shit. Like, if you're selling pussy and shit, yeah, you can get a little bit of money out of it, but you're not going to be like that much fucking rich. So why the fuck does she make it seem like she got rich on it?
I mean, that's the way that I feel. Just based off what I know about the game or whatever, she be talking a bunch of cash shit, and it's like,
ain't no
if you're dealing with a nigga that's like that, you ain't got that nigga to the point to where he just doing all that shit for you, and you his own.
You're just a hoe. You're just a hoe. You're just getting some pocket change from his ass. Now, in other words, to me, I feel like Megan just probably got lucky with the motherfucker that put her on in the game. She was doing the same shit, but she just got lucky with the motherfucker that was just stupid enough to fucking sign her. Yeah.
Okay, so you said Carl Crawford is one of her tricks. Okay, if the shoot fit word. Okay. All right, what about the city girls? How you feel about the city girls?
Yeah.
Okay.
Not to be ass fucked. I mean, yeah. If you rapping about that shit, you have fucked people in the day. Lil' Kim. If anything, I have more respect for Lil' Kim because it's just like, okay, she fucking about, like, I mean, she talking about the shit, but in a sense, like, she came more harder. It's a whole different generation. These people are actually, like...
So you feel like Lil' Kim was, like, actually, like, a stripper. And the rest of them, like, they was, like, you know, Lil' Kim was, like, actually a hoe.
They're teeny boppers.
You know, I'm not bad.
You're right, so Gucci gets us just, he's stressed out, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, come on. Hey,
y'all, that ass is bad. Y'all got to excuse this shit right there, bro. That ass is fat. I'm going to grab all that motherfucker. My hand going to be all the way over here. Yeah. You sit down. I'm about to get here with the man that these bills. Nigga, we show transport that shit today. Hold on.
Okay, y'all heard me.
Listen, nigga, this motherfucker wanted to cup some vodka, got a nigga on the level. Listen, man, where Dorothy out here, man, I'm on my own.
I'm doing what I do, I move around,
man, that's what I do. I told you, I live like this, man. Okay, shit, this is what it is. I'm crazy, shit. I am who I am. You gonna like it or love it, shit. Dorothy ain't here, okay? Dorothy resigned, alright? That's what happened, alright? She resigned, alright? Hell no. You gonna vote for Donald Trump?
Fuck no.
I'm voting for Trump.
You sure?
I'm voting for Trump. Shit, Trump got the hood paid. That's a train.
What is he doing? He's still at the end of the day.
You pay now. You fucked up tomorrow. What you mean? Trump is doing real shit. Trump hit up Lori Lightfoot the way us in Chicago. So little bitch, what you need? Trump is a real nigga. They can talk about him. You about to get hit with that man, that guy. Fuck you mean? I'm gonna get hit with that man act.
See, that's the only thing. Cause you, I mean, I'm not gonna lie. And then Trump, he said, if Kelly home, I'll vote for him.
You say what?
You
say Kelly home.
You don't like that. I feel like I just don't condone underage fucking shit. Like, well, okay, Jeffrey Epstein. Now that nigga, I don't know if he died in jail. I don't know. I'm still kind of curious, but I feel like if you're dealing with somebody younger, that's a problem. But
what
stupid
if the bitches
stupid,
were in love?
If they're willing to, you say yes. That's stupid.
So what you have you ever fought with an older nigga in your life?
That's all I fucking know. All my niggas are 50 years old. But my thing is, they never tried.
So what's the first time you fucked a 50-year-old? They want to let them know. When you were 21, what about when you were 18?
I didn't start for real fucking around.
Okay, when did you lose your virginity?
16,
17. Okay, so older nigga or younger nigga?
My age.
Okay. When the first time you fell with somebody that was substantially older than you?
21.
Okay, 21. Oh, okay. All right. So, when you was 18, you wasn't ready to fuck with an older dude?
Here's the thing. I had a lot of older dudes in my life. Like,
lawyers and all this other shit, which I kind of like, it turned me off. Like, yo, like this nigga just wanna fucking fuck with me just to fucking fuck. So we were not in that, or just like, you know, just always, I didn't like a lot of people being obsessed with me.
So why do you prefer older dudes? Is it because they know how to struggle with
it? No, because it's just the bull. It fucking struggles with the honest shit. You fuck with the older dude, they ain't gonna try to last long anyway, just to be honest. But, like, it's just, they don't have no bullshit. Like, you tell them what it is, and they're not gonna be like, okay, cool. Like, some of them, I'm not gonna lie, some older niggas can't be controlled. But, it is what it is. Like, you know what I mean? Like, they know your shit. They don't have time to play games. Like, yo, if I want to go out today, I don't expect you to teach about so, like, no, nothing. Like, you know, like just there's a certain shit that don't be expected to be bitched about, but whenever you're younger, you bitch about it.
Okay.
Like, if I want to be cute and whatever, as long as I'm coming home to you, what the fuck does it matter?
So if a nigga fuck with a bitch and she get her ass done, get her titties done, and all of that, but then she say she a victim of this dude and this dude try to rape her, when she use her money to try to come up off of and to sell more pussy, do you think she a victim or no?
Some people can be a victim, though, because like a lot of people look at you, okay, you got your titties and ass done because you're disappearing. Somebody's
gonna take advantage of you. That's like the person that you bought, the fucking ass and titties, don't even care about you because
they're more insecure
to
themselves about shit. Why
make anything? Well, what if that dude just gave you a bag and you went out and bought the titties
and ass yourself? That's just having you and your shit. But other than that, though, me as a man, if I feel like if I give you the money, basically, I would tell you not to do it. Like, if I'm really that strongly against it, then I'll come for it. I'll pay for it. But other than that, like, that means that you're not sure what the fuck you want. If you pay for somebody, they took an answer.
No, I mean, like, what if I just came in with you a bag at, like, 20 grand, like, here, spend it how you see fit, and you text me a picture and say, hey, daddy, I got some titties.
That's what she wanted. That's something that she had to fight for her own.
So do you think that person can come back and say that, oh, you took advantage of me?
No, they shouldn't. No, because that's what she wanted to do. And I have her situation like that. Like, I only got my ass done because you wanted me, no. Because you think you choose to go in and, like, alter your own body. But like, that's something that you want to do. Don't blame another nigga to do that.
So have you ever got your titties or ass done?
No.
Do you know people who have done their titties and ass done?
I mean, here's the thing though. When we danced whenever I was younger, I thought about it because, you know, I was a little skinnier. Mm-hmm. Now that I gained some weight, honestly, people don't understand. Like, it probably takes like a kid for you to get your hips. If you want hips, it probably takes anything to do whatever. Like,
mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I mean, so, you know, do you think that these same people who basically sell their bodies can come back and say, okay, somebody raped me? Would you burn your own car to get some attention?
Fuck nah. Because here's the thing.
Mm-hmm.
I need my fucking car. That's my own fucking car. And I don't just... And ain't nobody gonna help me pay for that shit.
Okay, but would you burn your car and then put on a face full of makeup with your ass poking?
That's what Azriel did. No. Hell nah. And whatever that R.K. little bitch...
He
just got a dumb bitch right there.
How you feel about Azriel, you know?
She lost. She just wants attention.
So do you think that he raped her?
I'm not gonna lie. I would've took advantage of her
because
she's a dumbass bitch.
Okay.
Excuse my language, but she's stupid.
No. The people, they wanna know.
I would've took advantage of her. If you going.
So you think she was going?
Yeah.
Okay, so let me ask you this, okay? If you find a female
and she's doing anal sex at the time of at the age of 15, right? Do you think that she's a victim, or do you think that she went home before?
To me, I feel like
I
still believe that that's the age of
2 years. No, I'm saying with R. Kelly.
Not even with R. Kelly, I'm just saying that's still the age of 2 years of having sex. Like, to me, like, it's too young to be, you could get molested
or you have been outside. Now, I can't control whatever happens because there is girls that kind of get more sexual, that gets more sexual whenever they're younger. But it's like a give and take. Like, I feel like a lot of people who prostitute, they had to have raped or been some type of molested during their whole time to be provocative.
Okay, so what? How old were you before you tried anal sex for the first time?
I don't know. I didn't have sex until like, shit, I didn't start sex like 22.
No, like, I'm saying anal sex, not vaginal.
Like 22.
Okay.
Like, that's a whole different, yeah. I can understand what you're saying, because anal sex is completely different than vaginal sex. Vaginal sex is the original form of penetration.
But I'm saying...
So, anal sex is bigger, but just say anal sex is some shit.
So, like, so you had to build up to anal sex. Anal sex was no shit that you was... Okay. I mean, I'm...
But here's the thing. I grew up with some white people, and white people thought that anal sex, as long as you have anal sex, you're still a virgin.
Okay. All right.
And I don't understand that, but...
You know, so do you, do y'all want to see Kontrol back on the show? You feel me? Do y'all want to see her back on the show? Let me ask y'all that question.
What's the dumb bitch?
The dumb, they talking about Azriel was a dumb bitch.
Yeah, she's still, to me, I feel like she's doing that shit for a show. To me, I feel like she was the person that thought that she was going to get out of it. And
you a real hustler. You a real hustler who do this. You ain't new to this. You true to this.
Yeah, I just wouldn't.
Okay. I mean, shit, the people want to know.
Yeah, she was stupid. To me, she was a bitch. I was going to go.
She was going?
Yeah. I can't understand, like, not even participating at, like, saying that his situation or her situation, but other situations, people has been victims.
So if you was fucking with a dude that's worth $900 million, would you turn on this nigga because he went to jail?
That's because you hating. The only person that's gonna end up putting out like that is because you hate.
Okay.
You're just bitter because you didn't get whatever the fuck you expected to get out of.
So if I had $900 million, you wouldn't turn on me.
$2 million.
I mean, but if you fuck with me, you fuck with me. You wouldn't leave me because I went to jail with you.
Money ain't shit. If you took care of me, and I'm cool if you went to jail, okay, cool. I won't say shit. Like, as long as I'm cool, whatever, like, your dude's gonna do whatever the fuck you're gonna, like, you allow them to do.
But, like, let's just say I was taking care of you, I was sending you on shopping spree, all of that.
But listen, let me finish, y'all.
If I was seeing your shopping sprees, but then I told you, hey, baby, look, ask you this. I can't see you on shopping sprees right now until I beat this case. After that, baby, it's going to be back on and popping. Would you quit fucking with me and leave me, or would you stay there and watch me beat the case?
This case too fucked up to even try to beat
I ain't talking about his case, I'm talking about to me, I feel like even going to that situation,
the reason why she's acting out is because she's not getting the money. Because she's not getting the benefits that she used to do. So she's trying to make a name for herself to sit up there and have people pay for her attention.
So do you know some hoes on the blade that are more down than her than she is? Do you know any hoes that you want to dance with?
My thing is that I wouldn't even sit down with a dude that's dealing with a whole bunch of bitches. Like, to me, versus my older dude, yeah, I gave him threesomes, but it's like, that nigga don't even care about the other bitch, though, or not even that. Like, it doesn't care about you because, like, you got to know your position. She didn't know her position.
Okay.
I feel like that. Like, that's how I feel. Like,
so what's the position?
Her position is just to shut the fuck up. Whatever she getting out the motherfucker, that's cool. Just leave.
Okay. So what's you know what I'm saying? How many threesomes have you had? Just acting. Okay. But you willingly participated.
Yeah, you willingly participated, that's what I mean. But other than that, like, I feel like if a person really cares about you, they wouldn't have put no extra person on the side. They wouldn't have. But okay. Hey, here's this bitch. Let's fuck each other. Like, here's the thing with our, like, he construed everything. He constructed everything.
But I'm asking you though, like, I fuck with you, but I got other bitches though.
Yeah. Okay, that's on you. If yeah, I know so. That, that's on you. Okay. Keep that shit to yourself. But. Right.
Okay.
Other than that, like I said, she's just mad because she's not getting her end of the bargain. Like,
what's her end? I mean, I guess.
Her end of the bargain because if you fucking your body, here's the thing, a lot of girls, whatever, if you're going to give your body, they're going to feel entitled to something.
So what's the average price of pussy? Like, not
it's no price to it. If you're giving it, you can have fucking $5. If I'm giving you some pussy, I want $4.50 out of that shit. Like, what the fuck you're fucking for?
Okay. All right. So.
That's what I'm just saying. Like, the fuck? Like,
have you ever fucked somebody and felt like you didn't get as much as you could have out the deal?
But here's the thing, though. If I put myself in a situation, if I lay down with that person, you have to expect if you get nothing or not. Yeah, okay. My thing is to just pick
and
choose the motherfuckers
you're
gonna fuck with.
Okay, so we can end this out on a note of how do you feel about Azriel, aka James Doe number 5, what would be your advice to that person?
You put yourself into that shit, and now you gotta live with that shit. All you gotta do is whenever the next situation, just she's too mentally fucked up anyway to get right now for that shit. But it's whenever you move on to the next person, you know how to play your role. Mm-hmm. If she would have played her role right and shut the fuck up, I'm pretty sure she would have got whatever the fuck she wanted to. But the fact that she keep on yang, I'm pretty sure, like, she broke down because of that. You gotta keep your mouth shut. A lot of those people in the industry, they got bitches that shut the fuck up. If they fucking screwed 10 bajillion girls and they still there, they still shut the fuck up. They're not going on the internet talking about you. They're not going on the internet doing nothing. Ooh. So... They know what the fuck
going on.
Those are the people that know what the fuck they got themselves into.
So, do you talk or do you shut the fuck up?
I listen and observe. So, at the end of the day, you're not
going to
catch me slipping.
Okay, you know, so, are you going to come back onto the show?
I can.
You feel me? Go ahead and show the people, flood your cash up real quick. If y'all want kontrol to come back onto the show.
You gotta hit that more button, right?
Okay, look. If y'all want to come back on the show, how much would you need to back on the show? Just hit your.
Okay, all right, let's cash out real quick.
Bless her cash out. If y'all want her to come back on to the show, you feel me? If y'all want more shows like this, where we get to ask people who actually like strip and dance, people who know people who sell pussy and shit like that. If y'all love these type of people, not saying that she sell pussy, but I'm just saying that she know people who might be prostitutes and shit like that. If y'all want these type of people to come onto the show, please bless her cash app, right? Please, you know, give her, you know, go. And follow her Facebook. All the fake shit, you know what I mean? Been to my crib and shit like that. You know, we've been fucking with each other for like 3+ years. I moved to Arizona. I moved back you know what I mean? We talk. We fall out of communication, fall back into communication. Like, we tight like that. We thick as thieves, you feel me? This is my real life, folks. So go ahead and hit her cash app, make sure you, you know, go ahead and drop that up in there for the people so I can put it up on the screen, you know. But yeah,
niggas gonna do whatever you allow them to do. So
okay, what you allow me to do?
Be my friend. So this is not so shit. You already know. This is not my
fans. I still love you, though.
Love y'all. Thank you, y'all. It's hot as hell.
Okay, go ahead and make sure y'all follow her on Instagram. You know, if y'all want to hear her cash out. Alright, y'all. Thank y'all for tuning in to the Opinionated Ladies Network. We'll try to bring y'all more interviews like this, y'all. Like, peace. Alright. God damn.